How do you improve on an already great printer? I'm Sockets, and I'll be guiding you through Cartographer installation step by step. The first step in this process is enabling root access and connecting securely through SSH. Open up Terminal and type SSH root at your printer IP. The default password is Creality_2023. Once in, the next step is installing the Gylus helper script. This will make things easier by grouping installers. The Git is in the description. Once we run the helper script, you'll need to navigate to the install section by pressing 1, then enter. We'll need to install the following in order: Moonraker plus Nginx, your choice of either Fluid or Mainsail, and Entware. Running Fluid and Mainsail together can cause issues, so only select one. After those are installed, the next step is to navigate to the K1 Clipper Update GitHub, provided by Zarbos. You'll find a link in the description. In the SSH session, we will navigate to the user data folder. Once there, we can clone the Git with the wget command. After this is completed, we'll need to give the installer permission to be run. The chmod command will do this. Once that's done, run the installer by typing .installer.sh. This install will take a few minutes, so be patient with it. Once the install is complete, you'll be prompted to reboot the machine. To do this correctly, we'll physically unplug the printer from the power supply, then plug it back in. The machine will flash the toolhead once that is complete. If we do not do this, there will be errors once we swap over to Fluid to continue the install. We'll now install Guppy. The GitHub page is in the description. You must disable Creality services, as these can cause issues. At this point, you can check the display on the printer to ensure Guppy is running. It's now time to install Camp. This is required to use the macros provided with Cartographer. We need to reopen the helper script, navigate to install by pressing 1, then enter, then install virtual pins and Camp. Once that install is complete, we'll install Camp. If you plan on using Orca Slicer, you do not need the macros for PersiSlicer. We'll now begin the Cartographer install. If your current directory in SSH is not root, please type cd space tilde. We'll clone the repo with the git clone command. Once this is done, we'll start the installer with the command directly below. This will take a few minutes. Once the installer for Cartographer is complete, we need to get the specific Cartographer's ID. To use this, use the ls command from GitHub. Save this in a notepad somewhere, as you'll need to reference it later. Now that we have that ID saved, it's time to move over to editing printer.config. Connect to either Mainsail or Fluid's UI and find your printer.config file. Shima is showing us Fluid as an example. We'll try to keep our configuration clean and tidy, so we'll make a new section for Cartographer settings. Once you're happy, we're going to replace the serial line with what we copied earlier. You need to ensure to have the path present, for example, dev serial by ID cartographer dash. Once we've added the Cartographer section, we'll need to change a few things in Stepper Z. We need to make a couple changes in this section. Find the lines end stop pin and position home and remove them. These need to be replaced with our new end stop pin and homing retract distance lines. This is because we are no longer using PR touch. We now need to make our final changes to printer config by editing our base mesh section. This is because the probing area is different. On the GitHub, there are two options. In this example, we are using the K1 Max provided to Shima by Creality. You'll need to use the section for whichever printer you are using. And because Shima is forgetful, we skipped a step. Go through your printer.config and comment out or remove anything related to PR touch. You'll encounter errors if you do not do this. The sections that you are looking for is PR touch V2 and all of the try max hold below that section. Once this is done, you can save and restart. Do not home the printer yet. There's still a calibration and safety step to do before we're ready to do this. Doing so could damage the build plate. Go back to the home page of your interface and press the Carto Calibrate button. This will home only the XY, move the tool head to the center of the bed, and start heating. You need to wait for the coil temperature to heat to at least 45°C during this process. If you print only ABS, set the bed temperature to 100°C and allow the cartographer to heat up to at least 65°C. This is usually a good middle ground for calibration, as the stock board cannot handle the temperature calibration process. To do this, press the little X on the probe calibration pop-up and manually set the bed to 100°C. You can reopen the calibration menu by pressing the manual probe on the tool selection. We are now calibrating the cartographer coil. This is done with the paper test. Please use standard copy your paper and adjust the height with the plus and minus buttons until the paper is barely touching the nozzle. Once you're happy with the offset, allow the cartographer coil to heat up to a minimum of 45°C, or if you print ABS, 65°C. You can then press the accept button, and once the calibration move is complete, save and restart. Please also keep in mind that if you swap build plates, you will need to redo this process. Failing to do so will likely damage the build plate. As you can see, Shima calibrated at 44°C. Once you hit accept, the printer will do some Z moves and forward movement on the tool head. Once this is complete, you need to save and restart. This is a very important safety check for first calibration. You need to do this to ensure the probe is functioning correctly. Go to the printer and manually lower the bed by spinning the front lead screws. The bed needs to be at least 20 to 30 millimeters away from the nozzle. To verify you're safe to continue, type M119 into the console. You should see the Z end stop state is open. This means you're safe to continue. If not, you need to troubleshoot by either recalibrating or ensuring you saved the config and restarted the printer. As we can see on Shima's example printer, the end stop state is open once it's away from the bed. This means they are safe to home all and continue to the final setup. You can now home all either by pressing the home all button or by typing G28 into the console. As a final safety measure, please be ready to emergency stop the machine. Something to note, when homing Z or running bed mesh, the camera will temporarily turn off as the MCU board cannot handle running the camera and meshing quickly at the same time. The final setup steps are a couple changes in the slicer. You need to edit the machine's start G-code. To do this, head over to your slicer of choice. Shima prefers Orca. Open up the machine settings and navigate to the machine G-code. Replace the contents with the provided G-code from GitHub. Don't forget to save these changes. You can now slice your first G-code and send it over to the printer. Let's take a look at what the printer's doing. A huge thank you to Creality, as well as everybody who's put so much time and effort into the software and the processes that have got us to where we are.